was the name of that great-great-grandfather of yours? The one that marched around here during one of the risings?
Jonathan Wolverton Randall. Oh.
He was, however, known by the more dashing nickname of Black Jack.
Something he acquired in the army, probably while he was stationed here. What are you up to?
I'm looking for that plant, the one that I saw in the stone circle. I don't think it was a gentian of any kind. The petals weren't rounded.
Well, why don't you go back and get it?
Perhaps, no, I have a better idea. Mrs. Baird's car is much safer, and it's only a short walk from the road to the base of the hill.
Only about 1,000 yards straight up from there.
There you are. I don't think I have a concussion. Oh, a movie! Well, they must be shooting a costume drama of sorts. Oh, I'm sure they wouldn't want me in it.
Not, though I do have a cousin by that name. Though I doubt it's he you have me confused with, madam. We do not resemble one another greatly.
Just who the hell are you?
I am, madam, Jonathan Randall, Esquire. Captain of His Majesty's 8th Dragoons at your service. The devil do you mean by running away like that? Oh, like that, is it? Well, I'd be most willing to oblige you. However, you've caught me at a most inopportune moment.
What the hell are you talking about? Get off of me!
Quite nice. Perhaps later when I have the leisure to attend to you properly. But who are you with? Frank. Whatever his name is. I have no man by that name among my company. Perhaps it was someone who lives nearby. They have the smell of dung about you. So you haven't been with a carter.
I haven't the faintest idea what you're talking about. And I ask you to please let me pass at once.
Not at present. At the moment, I'm asking myself just what a whore is doing abroad in her shift and her shoes, and quite fine ones at that.
Get off of me! My husband, he's to be wild.
And your husband? And what is your husband's name? Frank. And why does he let his wife wander through a deserted forest in a state of undress?
And who the hell are you?
This way.
What is it you have there, Murdoch?
Sassenach wench, Dougal, by her speech.
Come here, lass. What's your name, lass?
Clebuchon.
Where'd you find this, lass?
At the foot of Craig na Dun. She was having a few words with a certain captain of dragoons with whom I chanced to be acquaint. There seemed to be a question of whether or not the lady was or was not a whore.
I see. What was a lady's position in this discussion?
She said she was not. The captain himself appeared to be of two minds on the matter, but inclined to put the question to the test.
Yes, we will puzzle it out later. It's a long ways to go yet tonight. One day someone for Jamie first. You can't make the journey like that.
Mm.
Out of a joint.
Good bugger.
Fell with my hand over and the musket ball knocked me off my saddle. Landed with all my weight in the hand. Crunch. There it went.
Well, we cannot leave him behind now, can we? Jamie can hardly pass for an innocent cotter with yon great hole in him.
Dinna worry yourself, man. We'll no be leaving him behind.
Aye, and no help for it then. We'll have to try and force it back. I'll hold him. Rupert, you give it a try.
Don't you dare that! You have to get the bone of the upper arm in the proper position.
Get out of my way.
What do you mean?
He'll break his arm, that's what I mean.
Okay. This is the worst part.
It can't hurt much worse than it does. Get on with it.
It doesn't hurt anymore.
Can you staunch the lad's wound well enough for him to make the journey?
I can dress the wound, yes, provided you have something for me to dress it with. No, that won't do. The wound needs to be disinfected and bandaged with clean cloth, if there's no sterile bandages.
Disinfected?
Good. Here, bind these wounds quickly.
I can't use these.
Do it.
Moving like that. They come loose.
To get my plaid loose, I'll cover you. You're shivering. I can't do it one-handed.
Can you reach the cast my brooch for me? Didn't want you to freeze before we get there, eh?
Thank you. Where are we going?
Tell you the truth, Lassie, I don't know. But I can we'll both find out when we get there.
Put a blanket under his head and get me some water if there is some. Oh, you are not to move. Good grief. Oh, look at that. Oh, my God. And the idiot's been knifed, too. Seems like a blade of some sort has gone through the trapezius muscle.
A bayonet.
A bayonet? He needs rest and quiet. We should camp here at least until morning.
Nay, we're further than the garrison we'll venture. There's still the watch to be mindful of. We're 15 miles yet. 5 hours at least, more likely 7. We'll stay here long enough for you to stop that bleeding and bind the wound. But not much more than that.
Stop this.
The threats, is it? And after I shared my blood with you too.
No, no more spirits. He needs tea or water at worst, not more alcohol. No, stop it. For God's sake, do you want him so to be so drunk he can't stand up?
Feisty, wee bitch.
No. Denture business, woman. We've got a long way to go yet. And he'll need whatever strength the drink can give him.
Is it hurting now?
That is.
Good. You deserve it. I'll teach you to go herring on the countryside, kidnapping young women and killing people and...
Can you make the journey, man?
Oh, God, no, he can't go anywhere. He can't go anywhere at all.
Can you walk?
He'll take the lassie off my chest and fetch me a clean shirt.
Where are we?
We keep the castle there.
Jamie!
Jamie, my dear. Good to see you. Oh.
You'll be needing supper, I reckon. Plenty in the kitchen. Do you go out and feed yourself?
Claire, Mistress Fitzgibbons. Murtagh found her yesterday. People say we must bring her along with us. I'm going to find them in the kitchen. Right.
Well then, Claire. Welcome to you. Come with me and we shall find you something a bit more,
Oh, wait. I forgot Jamie.
But Jamie can fend for himself. He knows where to get food and someone will find him a bit.
He's hurt. He was shot and stabbed yesterday. I managed to bandage it, but I didn't have time to clean or dress it properly. I must take care of it before it gets infected.
Infected?
Well, yes. I mean, inflamed. With pus and fever and swelling.
Oh, I know what you mean. But do you mean to say you know what to do for that? A charm then? A beating?
Something like that.
Right, we'll go find him then.
The shirt will have to be taken off. And it will have to be cleansed with a solution for preventing fevers.
Well, what will you be needing?
Garlic, and if you have some witch hazel. I'll also need several clean rags and a bit of that boiling water you have.
I think we can manage that. What about a bit of comfrey then? And perhaps a bit of boneset tea or chamomile? The lad looks as though it's been a long night. My dear, what would you have me do?
If you could peel that clove of garlic. Things to do.
Lass, there aye be things for me to do. I'll send up a bit of broth for you. Do you cool oat if you need anything else.
It's no worries, lass. Got heart much worse. My people much less pretty. Lobster backs. Flogged me twice in the space of a week. That I'd done it twice in the same day, I expect. They're not afraid of killing me. No joy in flogging a dead man.
I shouldn't think anyone would do such a thing for joy.
No? Well, you should have seen him.
Seen who?
The recoil cap. Skinned my back for me. He was not precisely joyous. He was at least very pleased with himself. Or I was. Randall was the name.
Randall?
It was near 4 years ago. One day, young Captain Randall came to our place.
Well, couple spitfire scratch cats, have we here? A little bit of heart label will cure you, I trow. Or if not, you'll meet another cat by the name of Nine Tails. Then again, there's different cures for different cities. Isn't that right, my pussy?
I stripped off my shirt, down me at the wagon tongue. He was in a black fury. But we wished for the wear, you might say. That stung me a bit, but he couldn't keep it up for long. When he stopped, he turned to Jenny, one of the dragoons had a hold of her.
To see some more? Take me up to the house and show me some proper entertainment.
A maid called out on my sister,
tell her that I prefer to die than to have her dishonor herself with such scum. Randall took the blade from my throat, though, and thrust it between my teeth so I couldn't go out.
And what happened then?
She went with him. She thought he'd have killed me. I suppose she might be right. After that, I don't care what happened. One of the dragoons hit me on the side of the head with Stark's musket. When I woke, thrust up in the wagon with the chickens, shoulding down the road toward Fort William.
Oh, I'm so sorry. That must have been terrible for you.
Aye. Chickens are very poor company, especially on a long journey.
Oh. You really mustn't move that. In fact,
I thank you, Claire. You've a good cut. What is wrong, lass?
I'm sorry. It's my husband.
Oh, lass, are you widowed then?
No. Yes. I don't suppose I am.
Don't be scared of me. Nor of anyone here, so long as I'm with you. You need something hot. A wee bit of eat as well. Something in your belly will do better than anything. Do you get a bit of sleep, Claire? You're worn out. Lately, someone will want to talk to you before too long.
A long, long time ago, I picked flowers and sang on a